So I'm sure by now we all know that I'm a stationery addict. Yes, it's true. I admit it. I give into it. I am a stationery addict. So, like any stationery addict would, I'm always on the internet looking for new stationery to buy or trying to convince my mom to go to the stationery aisle of the grocery store in hopes of trying to find some really cool and aesthetic stationery. Nevertheless, there has been this one particular product that I had been eyeing on for around 6 months now. But it was the sort of product that I never really wanted to put my money into. I never really wanted to buy it, but I still wanted it. Fortunately, my birthday was just 3 weeks ago and I actually ended up getting it as a birthday gift. So I'm sure you're definitely curious as to what product I'm talking about, and they are the Zebra Mildliner brush pens. So I'm sure we've all heard of the famous Zebra Mildliners. They have literally been dominating the study community, the stationery community, bullet journal community, all those communities. So, like any fast and growing company like them, they decided to release a new line of products, which are basically the Zebra Mildliners, but in brush pen form. I did a review a while back on whether the Zebra Mildliners were overrated or not, so I thought I would take this opportunity to determine whether these brush pens are overrated as well. So in this video, I want to give you guys my honest take about these brush pens and also compare them with another famous brand of brush pens, which are the Tombow Dual Brush Pens. So before we start, here is just a little bit of my background experience with hand lettering and calligraphy. I have been doing calligraphy for around 3.5 years now. I would probably consider myself intermediate. The reason why I thought this was important to mention is because I think depending on your level in calligraphy, it can definitely change your opinion and perspective on how you feel about different brush pens. Anyways, let us go ahead and start with the comparison. So the first thing I want to talk about are the tips on both the brush pens. So both of these brush pens are double-ended, meaning they have both a brush tip and a fine tip. Starting with the Zebra brush pens, I would say that this brush pen is definitely smaller than the Tombow Dual brush pen. The tip is stiff, it's not very flexible at all. However, that is kind of a good thing for beginners, and I actually really like it as well, just because you have a little more control with the brush pens. I noticed that, at least for me, it was pretty easy to make distinct up and down strokes, meaning I could make super thin upstrokes and pretty thick downstrokes. I also noticed it kind of gave off a gradient-like effect, which I actually really liked. In terms of the brush tip on the Tombow Dual brush pen, obviously the tip is very flexible. It's significantly larger than the Zebra brush pen. For me, sometimes I still have a little bit of difficulty trying to control my up and down strokes, but I'm still working on that. The ink flow is also very consistent, meaning you don't get that same grading effect as you do with the Zebra Mildliners. One good thing about these brush pens is you can really experiment with your downstrokes. You can create so many different thicknesses. You can create a really thick, but you could also create a much skinnier one. In terms of the fine tip for both of these, I will actually say I really like the fine tip on these Zebra brush pens. The tip size for me is perfect. I always thought the fine tip on the original Zebra Mildliners was always just a little too big for my liking, but these are literally perfect. I love them so much. However, I do see these fraying very quickly. With my Zebra Mildliners, those fine tips are completely destroyed, completely frayed. So I definitely see that happening with the Zebra brush pens as well. In terms of the Tombow Dual brush pen, the tip, for me at least, is not a favorite. It does work really well. However, I just don't really like how it feels when you write with it, but obviously that is just personal preference. In terms of my experience with both of these brush pens, I will say I had a really fun time working with both of them. I genuinely enjoyed lettering with both of them equally. I will say that if I ever have to title my notes for a particular class, I'd be more likely to use these Zebra brush pens, just because since the tip is smaller than the Tombow one, I can actually fit my title in the space given, rather than with the Tombow Dual brush pens, I'm always struggling a little, just because I'm always writing a lot bigger because the tip is also a lot bigger. I also wanted to talk about the color ranges for both the brush pens. One thing that I was immediately curious about for the zebra brush pens is whether the color swatches on the brush pens were going to be the same as the mildliners. And after just doing a couple of swatches, I quickly determined that these swatches were literally identical. I could not see any difference. However, because these swatches are the exact same as the mildliners, that means that the color palette is pretty limited, whereas with the Tombow Dual Brush Pens, I believe there's like over 100 colors and they're all really pretty, all pretty pastel. With the Zebra Brush Pens, I don't see myself using the pastel pack as often, just because the colors are pretty neon, meaning that you probably would not be able to see them. So to answer your question, are the Zebra Mildliner Brush Pens overrated? Well, my honest opinion is that these are pretty overrated in the sense there isn't really anything that special about these brush pens. Like, they're good brush pens, they're pretty good quality. However, there's nothing really unique about them. I don't see myself wanting to hand letter, wanting to do calligraphy more because of these brush pens. Like, I think they're just kind of there. In terms of quality, I'd say honestly these are pretty good quality. However, I have heard a couple of people saying that these do fray really easily. I have been using them for 3 weeks and so far I haven't noticed much fraying. Unless you can find some really compelling reason as to why you need your highlighters and brush pens to match, I probably wouldn't really recommend this. However, if you do fall under this category of people, I would actually strongly recommend you to get these. So if you are someone that does not own the Zebra Mildliners and you have pretty like beginner to intermediate experience with brush pens, then I would highly recommend you to get these brush pens. The reason being, not only could you use this as a brush pen, you also get the fine tip, which helps you spice up your notes, and you can also use it as a highlighter because people use the Tombow Dual brush pens as highlighters, so why not use these as highlighters? And we've already determined that the swatches on the brush pen version and the highlighter version is the exact same. So highlighting it will be the exact same experience as just the original highlighters. So if you do fall under that category of people, I would strongly encourage you to buy it. Anyways guys, that is pretty much it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know your honest take, your honest opinion on these Zebra Mildliner brush pens. What do you think of them? Do you think you would buy them? Let me know. Yeah, so with that said, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys later. Bye!